Hi everyone, my name is Ashra and I'm part of the Azure Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team within Microsoft. As an admin, you may have a requirement to configure group writeback in your organization. In this video, let's discuss all about group writeback, how to enable disable it along with few known issues. Let's start with understanding what group writeback is. This feature enables you to use cloud groups for your hybrid needs by writing the groups back to an on-premises domain. It allows you to write back Microsoft 365 groups not only as distribution lists, but also as security groups or mail-enabled groups. It also allows you to write back Azure ID security groups to your on-premises as security groups. As part of this feature, nested groups will also be written back. To get started with the feature, let's first check if group writeback is already enabled in your organization. Open a partial window and import the AD sync module first. Post that, run the get AD sync AD company feature command and look for the group writeback feature in there. Here, we can see that it is currently disabled. To enable group writeback, let's first understand the prerequisites for it. This feature needs Azure AD P1 license and a minimum version of Azure AD Connect 2.0.89. If you need to configure cloud groups with Exchange, you would need an on-prem Exchange Server 2016 with cumulative updates CU15 or later. Once the prerequisites are satisfied, let's go ahead to enable group writeback on the Azure AD Connect UI. On your Azure AD Connect server, open the Azure AD Connect wizard. Select Configure and then select Next. Here, select the Customize Synchronization options and then select Next. In this page, you enter your credentials and once you do that, select Next. Here in the Optional Features page, verify that the options you previously configured are still selected. Here, select Group Writeback and proceed. In this page, select an AD organizational unit to store objects that are synchronized from cloud to your on-premises organization. Once that is done, select Next. Here in the Ready to Configure page, select Configure. Once that is done, select Exit. Since the new version of Group Writeback is still in public preview, let's understand the few limitations of it. Group Writeback does not support writeback of nested group members with the scope domain local, since Azure AD security groups are written back with the scope universal. If you have a nested group like this, you'll see an export error in Azure AD Connect with the message, a universal group cannot have a local group as a member. And the resolution is to remove the member with the scope domain local from the Azure AD group. Group Writeback only supports writing back groups to a single OU. Once the feature is enabled, you cannot change the OU you selected. A workaround for this is to disable group writeback entirely in Azure AD Connect and then select a different OU when you re-enable the feature. Group writeback setting to manage new group writeback at scale is not yet available. You will need to configure writeback for specific groups. I hope this video helps you understand what group writeback is and how to enable it. Thanks for watching.